If you ask about which animals can conquer humans by appearance, pandas must be one of them. Pandas are one of the most popular animals in the world. As of 2016, there are only about 2060 wild pandas in the world. The threatened level is temporarily at the vulnerable level. If it weren't for too few pandas, I believe many people would also keep them as pets. How much do you know about pandas? The ancestor of the panda is the earliest carnivorous panda that evolved from the bears. Scientists once found fossils of the jawbone and teeth of the ancestor of the panda in Spain. According to estimates, the fossil is about 11.6 million years old. Based on this, the ancestors of pandas originated in Europe and then migrated to Asia. Some experts believe that this can prove the theoretical hypothesis that pandas originated in Europe. However, some experts believe that the discovery of fossil jawbones and teeth does not prove the origin of the panda, because it may also be an ancestor with relatively close relatives, but it is now extinct. The origin of the panda remains to be studied. The pandas continue to evolve mainly in central and southern China. One of them appeared in the early Pleistocene about 3 million years ago. It is smaller than the current pandas. It is inferred from their teeth that they are omnivorous animals that eat bamboo. In this process, pandas have adapted to life in subtropical bamboo forests. Their hunting ability is very weak. That's the reason they are more herbivorous than most other bears. Generally, about 5 to 7% of their diet is meat. But their tree climbing ability is still good. According to archaeological excavations, pandas multiplied in Henan today and prehistoric times. Due to its huge size, in addition to providing meat and bone marrow, pandas were also favored by ancients for their beautiful fur, so they were hunted in large numbers. Nowadays, pandas have well-developed molar teeth, and their claws have a thumb in addition to the five toes. This thumb is mainly used to hold bamboo tightly. The panda has two most notable characteristics: a large body and a round face, which adapt to its bamboo diet. The panda's round face is due to the powerful jaw muscles, allowing them to bite apart bamboo. In proportion, the bite force of the panda is greater than that of the polar bear. The panda's coat color is formed because the two population bottlenecks of pandas occurred during periods of drastic climate change. The first occurred during the Pleistocene glacial period, and the second occurred during the last glacial period 20,000 years ago. If the brown or black coat of the bear family is more suitable for warm virgin forests, then the glacial forest is a black and white world of ice and snow. Black and white color are more conducive to hiding and disguising. After natural selection during the ice age, generally, the baby bears will follow the mother for 2 to 3 years. Adult male bears will actively look for female bears to mate in the spring. The panda's weapon has two pairs of sharp canine teeth, it like a guillotine, which can shred and tear any tough muscles and ligaments. That's the reason they don't need for continuous changes in color anymore. Pandas like to live alone, and each panda has a separate activity area. Half of the time they eat every day and spend most of the remaining half in their sleep. In the wild, pandas sleep for 2 to 4 hours in the middle of every two meals. Lying on their back, lying on their side, prone, stretching or curling up are their preferred sleeping style. In the zoo, the breeder feeds them regularly twice a day, so the pandas spend the rest of their time resting, which makes them more enjoyable. Regardless of their bulky body, they are very flexible and can put their bodies in various poses. Their favorite posture is to put the legs on the tree and cover their eyes with hands. Swimming, tracking, patient waiting, ice breaking attacks, direct attacks, and slamming. Little polar bears receive rigorous training from an early age like special agents. Compared with other omnivorous bears, brown bears are more carnivorous and often attack large animals. The only natural enemy of the brown bear is the tiger, Siberian tiger. Or take a nap. Although pandas have the opportunity to eat meat, they rarely prey on animals or look for their carcasses. This is not because they don't like eating meat. The grizzly bears in North America are subspecies of the brown bears. They can smash the spine of American bison with one palm, so it's easy to shoot people to death. Polar bears have a very keen sense of smell, about 7 times that of hounds, can smell seals several kilometers away, and can find seals in the snow layer 1 or 2 meters below. Pandas are divided into 2 subspecies, Sichuan panda and Qinling panda. The Sichuan panda is the black and white panda that everyone recognizes. Qinling pandas face survival difficulties today, in addition to human over-exploitation of the natural environment, but also competition from the natural world. For example, wild boars breed in large numbers and compete with pandas for bamboo shoots. The exotic species of larch will also eat away at the bamboo forest. As of 2018, there are about 345 Qinling pandas in the wild, which is closer to the edge of crisis than Sichuan pandas. Don't assume that they are colorblind just because they have an only black and white appearance. The cute panda not only has dark circles but also myopia. They accomplish the cognition of things through smell and sound. A group of researchers from Beijing Normal University once did an experiment on panda vision. Thousands of tourists and photographers from all over the world came here to watch wild polar bears, which in turn boosted the local economy. Through the movement of the cards with different patterns, observe whether the panda can distinguish the patterns of the cards. Churchill Bear Jail has also been established in the area to detain polar bears who are too close to the community or who are too fond of trash. After calculating the panda's age and gender for index analysis, the experimental results show that the panda's vision is about 0.32, which is equivalent to 127 degrees of myopia, and it is true myopia. The greenhouse effect led to the melting of the Arctic glaciers, which not only caused them to lose their habitat, their range of activities continued to move south. Males only have a few days of estrus in a year, and females have only 1 to 3 days of estrus in pregnancy. If they miss the estrus, they have to wait for another full year. In the breeding environment of the last century, 14 pandas were shipped out of China from 1936 to 1945. Among them, 5 were obtained from the London Zoo, but none of them reproduced successfully. We have introduced many members of the bear family, but who is the strongest among them? The next episode will be a special chapter on the ranking of the bears, so stay tuned. A pair of pandas given to the United States in 1972 took another 5 years to become pregnant for the first time after being sexually mature. In the following 10 years, 5 pandas were born but all died. Historically, the difficulty of panda breeding in captivity has made many breeders exhausted. Of course, these are only cases of artificial breeding. In fact, although the wild panda has a low fertility rate, it is similar than other bears. Wild pandas are gathering during the breeding season. To group marriages, several males will compete with others. Both males and females can mate with multiple heterosexuals. Both daily life and love are quite free. In contrast, many pandas in captivity can only live in small cages, and the mostly zoos can only raise 1 pair. It is a miracle not to suffer from depression and to be urged to marry. That's not love. 100% of pandas in the wild show reproductive behavior as adults, while only 26% of pandas in captivity show reproductive behavior as adults. So their fertility rate is actually good. To solve the problem of panda reproduction, it is necessary to start with the conservation of the natural environment and protect their habitat. Pandas have brought a lot of joy to us mankind. Hope that one day in the future, pandas can completely get rid of the crisis of endangered species. The next episode will head north, looking for another relative of the panda.